good evening. Today we're outside because it's warm, and why not? Let's talk about what happened in my audio evoked potentials test. Yes, it's a mouthful. So if you've been following my hearing aid saga, you might remember that I was referred for a bunch of tests. This was when my hearing test didn't quite match up to the experiences I was having. It was at that point that I was diagnosed with audio processing disorder, which you can learn more about up here. But I was also referred for audio evoked potentials test, which is basically to assess for auditory neuropathy and also looks at underlying causes like MS, brainstem stroke, and some other things, but let's not go into that because that's a whole deep dive. Normally I would walk through the letter that I received, which had the date and time and all of the instructions for the appointment on it, but I have lost that because I'm not actually in my house at the moment. I'm cat sitting, and the letter is somewhere. I may have taken it home, I may have lost it en route, who knows. The only thing that was really weird with my appointment is that I actually had to phone up to confirm my appointment when I received the letter, because I don't know if they're busy or what, but they schedule out like a whole portion of the day, which is a long waste of time if somebody's a no-show, so you do have to call and confirm. I had to reschedule mine because I was not at home when I received the letter, and then it was a couple of days after. And it was also scheduled for June, which, if you did watch my June in review, was so busy. Ridiculously busy. So I had it this month instead. So an evoked potentials test is effectively a hearing test, but one that you don't have to push the button to. So you have headphones on, you have sensors on, they'll play you the sound and they will measure how your brain reacts to it. I had a sensor on the top of my head, I had one in the middle of my forehead, and one behind each ear. And then they played me a bunch of sounds in different circumstances and measured my brain activity. So the first part of the test was the worst, just because it was really long and irritating, in my opinion. They put headphones on, and you know how headphones can sometimes cause pain after a while? Well, I was instructed to not move, and the test took about an hour, and I was in quite a bit of pain towards the end, and I ended up getting quite annoyed with the length of the test, and they could tell by my brain activity. Oops. Not at any point did I take it out on any of them, I just sat with it. So they start you off with these headphones, your sensors are on, and then they play you beeping at various frequencies and volumes. And while you're doing this, they encourage you to play on your phone to keep you awake, because it's an hour of not really doing much. I was doing a little colour by numbers thing on my phone, which is very relaxing. So I did that for about an hour and waited for the pain to go away. That's a lie. I waited for the doctor to come back in and take off my headphones because I didn't want to move and have to do any of the test again. And the next part of the test is they also put headphones on you again. You've still got your sensors on, one behind each ear, one on the forehead and one on the top of the head, and then they say, right, go to sleep. As if that's easy. But I just lay down and shut my eyes and hope for the best. Hello. Ignore that, I've got an umbrella up for wind noise. Just lay down, and then they played lots of clicking sounds in my ear, and then that was a much quicker test, I think. Unless I actually did fall asleep. I don't know. But they measured my brain activity from there, and that was kind of it. An irritating thing though was they wouldn't stop talking about printers, because they lost a printer in the department, and that's all I could hear over some of the beeps sometimes. Phone went off at one point and they answered it and spoke, and I was like, is this gonna come up in the brain thing? And it probably will have done, but I think they accounted for that. The test overall took about 2 hours. My appointment is at 1, and then I left the clinic at about 3, There was obviously some setting up and setting down time from that, but it was just generally very simple. I don't really know how to describe it because there was nothing really to describe, but I promised I would. A lot of the information that I looked up when I was like, what is an evoked potentials? It was all visual, and the auditory one kind of got left behind, but it was, I promise, it was very easy and quite comfortable for the most part. Just make sure that the headphones are actually comfortable for long-term wear, if you know what that's gonna feel like. I evidently didn't, so what was comfortable at the start wasn't comfortable at the end. With results, they can't really give you the results in the appointment because they have to like go away and like analyze it and like look at the graph shapes that they've been given and like interpret what this actually means and compare it to your hearing loss charts and other diagnoses and all sorts of external information that they don't always have to hand in the appointment. But they can look at general trends and say, this is kind of normal, this is kind of abnormal. Mine, they said, was generally normal but not perfect, but it was in line with my hearing tests, so that seems to be good. From what they said, I'm not looking at any new diagnoses, really. There might be some next steps, there might not be, I don't know, but I will keep you updated because I know you all care so much about what's going on with my ears. I barely do anymore. Did ask to be CC'd into the results, but they said that they don't do that, but they will write to audiology and hopefully audiology will write to me. So if I actually ever get results, you'll be the first to know. Well, you'll be the second to know because I would also like to know. But if you haven't been watching my month in review videos, you should be, because that's where I'm putting a lot of my audiology kind of results that are just very simple and don't really deserve their own video. This barely did. Did I have to do any special preparation for the test? No. I made sure that I peed beforehand because I didn't really feel like going to the bathroom in hospital right now. And I also didn't want to have to sit there needing a wee or anything else. So I just made sure that was out of the way, but that's just like my own personal comfort. They didn't ask me to do that and it's not required for the test. I think if you had to pee, you could get up and go, but then you'd have to reattach sensors and everything. Sensors were attached with like a sticky paste glue type thing. Yes, it did get in my hair. Yes, I did wash it out. It was very simple. And they do kind of clean you up before and after so that you don't like have to leave with glue on you. Didn't have any reaction. There was a tiny, tiny bit of itching, but I just ignored it and carried on playing on my phone and it went away. There! Go away, wasp. I'm gonna just run away real quick. Yee. I'm gonna get my camera man. Okay, so there was a wasp. I have now evacuated the filming area. And I have evacuated my entire train of thought. So if you have any questions, put them down in the comment section below. Don't laugh at me for running away from a wasp while you're there. Like this video, subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, and ring that notification bell so you get notified every single time I post a new video. Videos go up every Saturday at 6 p.m. UK time with at least one bonus video every single month. See ya!